Welcome back to Let's Play Song of the Ocean, Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari, heading toward Selbart, but you wouldn't know it from here. Oasis is back that way. The people in Selbart, I hear, are very... they don't like outsiders. Insular community, I guess you'd say. So... it makes sense why they're not advertised on the sign. Should be interesting talking with these people. Just looking for any secret chests or anything. Okay. Looks like you can walk up there, right? That one got knocked on the head or something. I'm just trying to look at every side, because these are kind of whitish. All the desert areas seem to be like wide open like that. I almost ran into that one. Oh, there's a chest there. I didn't even see that. So focused on the creatures. Monsters. Orb of Ocean 31. Nothing different in particular. Sometimes behind you find something else. Alright. No. I don't know why I always do that. 31, I said? Image of a serious Slade. Selbart. Is this the other side? Is that... I guess this is where we came down. That's where we've been. To the right. Yeah, I mean, we can't get around it. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna guess that's what it is. I'm surprised they even have a sign outside their city. I thought it was gonna say, like, visitors keep out or something. All these purple-haired ladies. Fred says, we are here. Welcome to Selbart. Una says, Selbart's located on a pretty steep slope. It's highly possible that we can find a resonance stone in the underground ruins, says Forte. Fred says, the problem is whether they will let us in there or not. McBain says, because the ruins are a sacred place, I hope you'll be able to fix things up with the villagers. Don't worry, says Ada. All we need is to become friends with them. I hope we checked out Fred. Well, we got six whole people. But only four can attack at one time, but Jan and Rick count as like a half each, I guess. Doesn't seem fair. So, equipment. So he already has a sword or shield, and sword or armor, which is like the best stuff. We'll give him this economy ring. And not the call bell, because we don't want to draw monsters to us. Let's say we have the call bell on one of us and the noise bell on the other. I guess it just they just cancel each other out. Yep, it be Selbart. Hi. Elma says, ma'am, right on. Nanai says, what are you talking about? You yourself aren't bad either. They were not even looking at Forte and the company talking up a storm about gossip. Sounds like they're just complimenting each other, though. Do you know that husband is... Wow, really? Says Elma. Yeah, sworn about gossip. Got it. Zane says, I know you're here for the ruins, right? The outsiders are not allowed to go in there. Just give up and go home. Damn. Adan says, outsiders, eh? Are you sure you're not bandits? No, we are not, says Forte. Can you tell? Can't you tell by our appearance? We are troubadours. Huff. You never know. That could be a disguise so that no one would be suspicious. If you do something stupid in this village, I'll kick you out in no time. Remember that. Remember what again? I'm warning you. You should leave now. Why is that? Asked Una. The village was attacked by the bandits the other day. Since then, people are pretty nervous. You don't seem to be bad people, but the people here don't welcome outsiders much. Yeah, got that. Oh, the inn is inside a cave? Wow, guess it's nice and cool in here at least. Maybe. She doesn't talk, right? No. There's another cave there. Well, let's go look around down there before we start messing around with caves and ladders and stuff. Couldn't get down for a second. Whoops. Una says, wow, they sure don't practice like a mere rehearsal. Yeah, I can totally feel their enthusiasm, says Forte. McBain says, their talent bestowed by God is not the reason why the Shannon tribe excel in music and dancing. It's all due to their long-standing work ethics. Okay. Oh, we can't try to talk to them. We'll just go through that. Oh, what we got? A snake sword for Forte. Or Fred. Long sword with a flame-like pattern on its blade. Very sharp, easy to use. And we got a new spear for Ada. Pierce spear. A holly bow for Una. Bow made of holly tree. Two thin plates are laminated for added power. And this one is spear with a prism tip. A veteran can pierce to an armored enemy with it. I don't have money for all this. Victor glove? Said to bring victory to the wearer. Lead is embedded in the palm for power. There's a large shield, which Fred or Forte could use. A fairly large oval shield, worn on the shoulder so mobility will be restricted. And new armor, chain shroud. Armor made with woven wires, a reliable protective gear, but it makes loud noise. Makes loud noise, huh? Okay. So what if I get... She's chain shroud for everybody. Can't get everything. Hoping the sword or sword sell for a good amount of money. I don't know why the music, like, it sounds like it's about to skip, right? Like it's playing on a vinyl record. Alright, well, pierce spear for Ada. We don't even use Ada in combat. We'll get a holly bow for Una. 550. Yeah, okay. And a large shield for Forte and Fred. Okay, large shield. Defense only up by one, though. Doesn't seem significant. And a large shield for Fred. Defense up by one. And we got Una's bow. Defense up by one and attack up by 10. Alright, sell the other things. Two sword or shields. And a thunder bow. Your 200 left. Oh, I didn't do the exchange yet, did I? Let's exchange. Well, that helps. I might not get 8 of that spear. Not yet, anyway. But McBain's glove, Victor glove, which has lead in the palm. Attack up by 10, defense up by 1. That's how it seems to be going, right? Sell the roaring glove for 1700. Now the sword, the snake sword, I can't afford. Oh, that rhymes. Forte and Fred, so two snake swords, we need 8,000. I was skipping the pierce spear for now, unless I have money left over. The bow is good, the glove is good, the shield is done, and I need sword or armor for not sword, but chain shroud for everybody except Una, I guess. I don't know if it's worth it to, like, get her avoidance down to 15. To get her defense. Up from whatever it is to 133. The defense now is 85, so yeah, maybe we should forget about that. But in any case, I need more money to get any of this stuff, right? Can't just get one, right? Even one thing? Snake sword. Sword or armor. Well, we can get sword or armor for someone. I mean, not sword or armor. Chain shroud. One chain shroud. Defense up by 7. The armor only sells for 900. Wow. 2,300. So I need another 1,000 for the next one. Well, hopefully we come across some money. Oh, there's a chest over there. Oh, there's a cave over there. Orb of Ocean 97. Orb of Ocean 11. I mean 100. Why did I say 11? Is it 97 and 100, right? A 100 is image of Kachua smiling. 97 is image of Argus. Okay. Oops, I ran into the thing. Huh. What's off this? Yeah, curious. I was curious if they'd let me go off the screen, and if so, it was there, and I found the answer, so. Okay, cave. Hello? Sharon says, "Excuse me, but who are you? Please don't enter without permission." "Sorry about our rudeness," says McBain. I mean, there was no door. "We are the McBain Company. We are the troubadours." "Oh, so you're musicians." "I don't think those who like music are bad people, but I've been careful because bandits attacked here recently. If you want to perform here, you must have a good skill, since Selbart is famous for music performances." I think we have that. We got it made with all these caves, huh? Okay. So I got a cave and stairs. Or a ladder. Grandpa Bagel says, "What brought you here to Selbart?" "We're the McBain Company," says McBain. "A group of troubadours. We are looking for something connected to the composer called Leon Friedrich Richter."
"Leon.
I take it you know him."
I must not say anything. Ask Chief."
"Where does Chief live?" asked Forte.
"The furthest house by the west cliff." "If you want to know about Leon, ask Chief Odessa. Chief lives in the furthest house by the west cliff."
"Okay." Hello? Item shoppy? Nothing here, right? Water ball? Fireball? Only useful, I'm sure, but we're saving up for armor and a weapon or two. Oops. Tricky going down this one. Alright, so I guess he's down this passageway. I mean, this is the west cliff. Oh wait, did we go up those stairs? Oh, there's no one in this one. Maybe I didn't go in this one. pretty cool. Nobody's in here either. Oops. Peoples. Look, says Forte. Don't fall off the cliff. Oops, says Ugo. They found us. Tam says, run! And jump. Ada says, excuse me. Don't look at me like I'm a monster. Didn't even give us a chance to talk to them, says Fred. Let's look one more time. By some magic. No, Chief's still not here. Did I go in this one? Yeah, this is the other empty one. So we got a cave there. Wait. We got a cave there. Okay. Am I supposed to be looking for them now? Oh, this is them, right? Ugo says, my mom warns me not to talk to outsiders. Sorry. How rude, says Ada. Before anything else, you need to learn not to be rude to a person you meet for the first time, brat. Come on, Ada. You're scaring the hell out of them, says Una. Sorry. You're probably more scary than Uncle Seedol. How scary is he? Get back here. Stop walking all over. My god, you're pacing. Tam says, you have music instruments. Are you musicians? Yes, we are, says Forte. But I heard that entertainers from outside are nothing but poor performers. Are you pretty bad, too? Forte doesn't answer. Nah. Well, that was illuminating, but where's this chief? Furthest house by the west cliff. Well, I guess we haven't been there yet. I don't know. So maybe it's down there. Well. And as far as down there, I mean this way. Maybe just a disconnected area like, what's his name's workshop. Huh? Are you the chief? Let me look around. I'm making sure there's nothing hidden. There's another person in there. Okay. Sidol says, this is a chapel where you offer a prayer to God. Oh, it's not the chief's house? You foreigners need to leave. Excuse me, says McBain, but is the chief of Selbart here? Certainly. And you are? We're the McBain Company, a group of troubadours. We're here to pay our respects to the chief. It's a commendable attitude. Chief is offering a prayer right now. Please come another time. We've been so polite to them, says Ada. But why do we have to come back again? Yeah, big head, says Fred. The warrior narrowed his eyes and gave them a fierce look. Scary, says Fred. Well, what are we going to do? We have to come back later. What a nuisance. Let's go bother the old man again. Wait a second. What else is going on? Oh! Don't I know that person? Argus says, you're the McBain Company, aren't you? Kachua says, wow, it's been a long time. And you're... Oh, I remember, says McBain. Long time no see. Argus the Sitaris. Yeah, I remember him. From near the beginning of the game. Kachua the Dancer, says Una. Glad you remember us, Kachua said. I heard that things at the party on Ryotam Island went really badly afterwards. Or maybe we met them at Ryotam. That seems so long ago as well. It didn't even cross my mind, says Argus, that we were brought in for the purpose of kidnapping. There's no way Rish can get away with this. I'm sure he's got enough punishment, says Fred. Huh? You look familiar, says Argus. Aren't you Diplomat Slade? Ah. I retired from being a diplomat. Now I'm apprentice for the McBain Company. I don't think I've met you before, says Kachua. Oh, nope. I'm Ada. Nice to meet you. She's a skilled puppeteer, says Forte. I'll have Pedro say hi to you, too. Come on. Nice meeting you, Pedro says. Pedro bows gracefully before everyone. Wow, how cute, says Kachua. It's really well made, Argus says. Thanks, says Ada. Hey, guys, says Kachua. I'm sorry that the villagers were rude to you. Argus says, Selbart has a long history of being attacked by bandits who were after the treasures in the ruins. Armed bandits attacked us recently. Everyone is very nervous. Please forgive us if we have offended you. Argus bows deeply. We don't care, says Forte. It's not like they harmed us physically or anything. That's a crazy thing to say. Excuse me. It would be a shame if we couldn't get to know the villagers because they're suspicious of us, says Ada. I know a good way to become friends with them, says Fred. Why don't you give a performance with Argus and Kachua for fun? If we can convey that we enjoy performing, we mean we. You don't perform. People will know that we are not the enemies and open up to us. That's a good idea, says McBain. People in Selbart respect those who are good at performance and dancing. You might be able to change their opinions of you by performing. Yes, it's a different way of saying the same thing. I will dance with Pedro, says Ada. What are we waiting for then, says Kachua. Let's get going. We'll be there as soon as we're ready. Wait for us at the ballroom. There's a ball. Oh, right. That carpet. Well, then, says McBain, we'll have to see if our performance will be good enough to gain the trust of the villagers. I love this kind of tension, says Forte. By the way, Mr. McBain, says Fred, what can I do? Good question. How about singing, says Una? I'm poor at empty casks. Then you take charge of smiling, McBain says. Haha, you know what I'm good at. Okay, smile. How do you like my smile? Let's head to the ballrooms, McBain says. Sorry for having made you wait, says Kachua. I brought the villagers. Welcome to the concert of the McBain Company, says Ada. First of all, enjoy an opening performance. How many performances are there going to be? Oh, she's the opening performance? Hello, this is Pedro. Pedro says, kinda, hey, how's it going lately? Wow, says villagers. Pedro greet them by turning around. Okay. Oh, you mean turning someone else around? You turn around, says Ada. Just kidding. Let's get serious now. Wow, the villagers say. That performance was by Pedro the Marionette. What should we play, Grandpa? People here prefer intense music. I think upbeat music will be good. Gotcha, says Una. Do I have to choose? I don't remember which... Okay, good. Traveler's Prelude. Thank you.